Stay home. Save lives.
Hello students, how are you? I hope so you have watched my previous video. Now in this video, I am going to explain you about the parallel plate capacitor, its principle, and we are also going to derive the expression for capacitance with and without the dielectric. Okay, now what is a parallel plate capacitor? A parallel plate capacitor is an arrangement of two thin conducting parallel plates separated by a certain distance. Now what is the principle? On what principle does it works? Let me explain you. Okay, now it works on the principle that capacitance of a charged conductor can be increased by bringing another uncharged or low potential conductor near to it, separated by some non-conducting medium. Let me explain. Now here in this figure you can see we have taken one metallic plate A, okay, and some charge is given to it, a positive charge is given to it. Now this charge is given till the potential becomes maximum. Okay, let the potential of the plate A be V. Let the potential, maximum potential of the plate A be V. Now bring another uncharged conducting plate B close to it. Now because of induction, negative charge will be induced on the nearer face of the plate B and positive charge will be induced on the other side of the plate B, on the further side we can say. Okay, now because of this negative charge, the potential will reduce. Reduce by how much factor? It will reduce by minus KQ by R. Yes or no? And because of this positive charge, the potential will increase by the factor KQ by R. But since negative charge is more close to the plate A, the potential will decrease. Yes or no? The potential will decrease. Why? Because the negative charge is more close to the plate A. As a result, the net potential will decrease. And when the potential decreases, we can supply more charge to the plate A to bring it back to the same potential. Now suppose if the plate B is connected to the earth, what will happen? The negative charges from the earth will flow and neutralize this positive charge, leaving behind only the induced negative charges. Yes or no? Okay. So earthing, what does it do? It neutralizes the positive charges, leaving behind only the negative charges on the plate B. So as a result, the potential will further reduce. Further reduce, and more charge can be given to A to bring it back to the same potential. So thus we can see that the storage capacity has been increased by bringing some uncharged conductor or low potential conductor near to plate A. So this is what is the principle of a parallel plate capacitor. And this arrangement is known as parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so now students, we are going to derive an expression for the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. Okay, so here in this figure you can see we have taken two conducting plates A and B parallel. They are parallel to each other and they are separated by a certain distance D. Okay, now suppose a plate A is given a positive charge Q and plate B is given an equal negative charge. Let the charge densities of the plate A be plus sigma, and for the charge B, let the surface charge density be minus sigma. Okay. Now because of these charges, the electric field between the plates is given by E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught, where epsilon naught is what? The absolute permittivity of free space. We have learnt in the previous chapter. Yes? Okay, so electric field between the plates is given by the expression E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Also, we know that E is equal to V by D, where V is what? V is the potential difference between the plates. Okay, so we can write V is equal to E into D. Or we can say V is equal to, we can sigma D by epsilon naught. Here we have substituted E as sigma by epsilon naught. So we get the expression V is equal to sigma D by epsilon naught. Now what is sigma? Sigma is surface charge density, which can also be written as charge per unit area. So I have written sigma as Q by A. Now A is what? A is the area of these plates. Okay, so we got the expression of potential difference as V is equal to QD by A epsilon naught. Now the capacitance formula is C is equal to Q by V. We will substitute here the expression of V, that is QD by A epsilon naught, and we get the expression A epsilon naught by D. So the expression for a capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, you can see it is A epsilon naught by D. So from this expression it is clear that neither it depends on the charge nor it depends on the potential. It only depends on the area and the distance between the plates. Capacitance, it is directly proportional to the area of the plates, and it is inversely proportional to the distance between the plates. Okay students, so just now we have derived the expression for capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when it was filled with air or vacuum. We got the expression C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. Now suppose if these plates are separated by a dielectric medium of permittivity epsilon, then the same expression can be written as Cm is equal to epsilon A by D. That means this is the capacitance when a medium is placed between the two plates, when a dielectric is placed between the two plates. So expression is epsilon A by D, and as you have studied in the previous chapter, epsilon can be written as epsilon R epsilon naught A by D, where epsilon R is what? Relative permittivity. Yes, so epsilon R epsilon naught A by D, or which can also be written as K epsilon naught A by D. As you know, epsilon R is equal to K, and K is what? It is the dielectric constant of the medium. So when you compare both these equations, you get C is equal to K C naught. That means the capacity when a medium is placed between the two plates, its capacity increases by K times compared to when it is filled with air or vacuum. Okay students, now next we are going to derive the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when partially filled with dielectric. The word partially, please remember. Okay, now here we consider two conducting plates A and B. Let the positive and equal negative charges be given to these plates. Now due to these charges, the electric field between the plates is given by E naught. Okay, now let us introduce a dielectric slab of thickness T between these two plates. Now remember, this thickness T is less than the separation between the plates. The separation between the plates is D. Okay, so that means a dielectric of thickness T is placed between the two conducting plates A and B. Okay, now the applied electric field was E naught, but when a dielectric is placed between it, due to polarization, negative charges will be induced on this side and positive charges on the other side of the dielectric. Due to these induced charges, an induced electric field will be produced, and the direction of the induced electric field is opposite to the direction of the applied electric field. This induced electric field is represented by the term EP. Is it clear? Okay. So that means the net electric field inside the dielectric will be equal to E naught minus EP. Yes or no? E naught is the applied electric field and EP is the induced electric field due to polarization. So that means the net electric field inside the dielectric will be E is equal to E naught minus EP. Okay, now let us find out the potential difference between the plates. Now potential difference between the plates, we'll divide it into two parts. one where it is filled with air or vacuum, and the second where it is partially filled with dielectric. Now potential difference for the case when it is filled with air, for the portion in which air is filled, and that portion is D minus T. So potential difference between the plates for this case, for air, it will be E naught D minus T. Okay, plus E into T. E into T is the potential difference across this dielectric. Okay, so net potential across these plates will be E naught D minus T plus E into T. Okay, or E naught D minus T plus E can be written as E naught by K. You remember in the first chapter we have studied. Okay, so it can be written as E naught by K into T. What is K here? K is the dielectric constant of this medium. Okay, so we can now take E naught common, and inside the bracket it will be D minus T plus T by K, or E naught. E naught can be written as sigma by epsilon naught. So sigma by epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. Okay, we got the expression D is equal to sigma by epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. Now sigma is what? Sigma is the charge density, okay, which can be written as charge per unit area. Okay, so A is what? The area of the plates. So we got the expression V is equal to Q upon A epsilon naught, and in the bracket it is D minus T plus T by K. Now what is the formula for capacitance? Capacitance C is equal to Q by V. C is equal to Q divided by, now we will substitute V from here. So you will get Q upon A epsilon naught bracket D minus T plus T by K. Q, Q will cancel, and we get the expression C is equal to A epsilon naught bracket D minus T plus T by K. Okay, so we got this expression C is equal to A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. So this is the expression for the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when it is partially filled with dielectric. Okay, so further we can also write it in this form, C is equal to A epsilon naught. Now from denominator D I have taken it common, so inside the bracket it will be 1 minus T by D plus T by D K. Okay, or you can also write C is equal to C naught 1 minus T by D 1 minus 1 by K. As you know, C naught is what? C naught is the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when it is filled with air or vacuum. And you know the expression for capacitance C naught is what? A epsilon naught by D. And here we have taken in this, from these two terms we have taken T by D common. So inside the bracket is 1 minus 1 by K. So this expression actually tells you the comparison between the capacitance when it is filled with dielectric and when it is completely filled with A. Okay, so you got the expression C is equal to C naught 1 minus T by D inside the bracket 1 minus 1 by K. Okay girls, so in this video we have learnt about the parallel plate capacitor. So please go through it thoroughly, learn it, and take care. Thank you.